Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have a lot to cover today for standard updates with upcoming launches, Crew Dragon and Starlink. It's then over to Boca Chica with infrastructure, Starship and Super Heavy updates. Let's head straight in and get up to date. September has been a long month with just one launch so far but many delays and scrubs. SpaceX were targeting both of their next launches for Thursday, but that once again has changed. SpaceX tweeted this absolutely epic shot of two Falcon 9 vehicles vertical at the same time in Cape Canaveral. The caption for the tweet said, "Targeting Thursday, October 1st at 9:17 a.m. EDT for launch of Starlink. Due to a conflict on the range, now targeting launch of GPS-3 on Friday, October 2nd, 15-minute window opens at 9:43 p.m. EDT. In terms of upcoming launches, there was another tweet from SpaceX with this picture of a new Crew Dragon. The tweet said, "After launch of Crew Dragon's first operational mission with astronauts on board, SpaceX will launch its 21st cargo resupply mission to the ISS. The first to use the upgraded version of Dragon outfitted for cargo missions." In response to that tweet, they said, "Once this Dragon docks to the space station, there will be two Dragons docked simultaneously. Between crew and cargo missions, there will be at least one Dragon spacecraft attached to the ISS for the entirety of 2021. We have a confirmation from Kathy Luders, NASA's Human Spaceflight Program Leader, on when Crew 1 should launch. She tweeted that they are now targeting liftoff at 2:40 a.m. Eastern Time, October 31st or 6:40 a.m. UTC. With regards to this mission, SpaceX tweeted this picture of the crew in front of their ride to space. They tweeted it saying, "SpaceX training of astronauts that will fly on board Dragon's first operational mission is complete. When the crew arrives for pre-launch preparations at the launch site, they will participate in a run-through of day of launch activities with the launch and pad operations teams." Since it's relevant to the Crew 1 mission, there was a tweet from reporter Lauren Grush. She said, "NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins announces the name of their Crew Dragon for Crew 1, Resilience, an apt name for this year." There is another tweet from Michael Baylor with some interesting information. What he said is, "SpaceX is targeting no earlier than October for a Falcon 9 mission featuring a return to launch site recovery per an FCC filing. No missions on SpaceX's publicly known manifest seem to be a good fit. It could possibly be an unannounced mission. After having multiple successful demo flights of Crew Dragon capsule, SpaceX and NASA are now working on finalizing the spacecraft certification. There are a few minor changes that are being reviewed, but apparently these will be complete for the upcoming Crew 1 mission." Washington Emergency Management tweeted about Starlink. They said, "Happy to have the support of SpaceX's Starlink internet as emergency responders look to help residents rebuild the town of Malden that was overcome by wildfires earlier this month." Somebody asked Elon Musk about the Starlink IPO. Musk responded to say it wouldn't happen for years to come. He was asked if retail investors could get shares earlier, Musk said they would get top priority. "As an investor myself, I for one am all for getting early access." So with those exciting updates covered, we'll see more work in Boca Chica. Last episode, we saw a tank from the tank farm taken down and placed on a trailer. It's now been moved away. Interestingly, it has been placed over by the old gas well lot. Other tanks have also been stored here for quite a while. Talking about the tank farm though, I believe nearby this new weather station was erected. Not far away at the new orbital launch mount, they've been pouring concrete into the supports for the structure. Also near to the launch mount, there's been groundwork going on. Nearby the mount at Pad A, the new structures we've seen are getting closer to completion. After recently removing the thrust simulators from the Pad B mount, engineers continue to work on it. When SpaceX tested SN7.1, they used rolls of steel to help hold it down. These have been moved away from the launch area. In the production area, a new downcomer and thrust puck were moved after arriving recently. Other pieces that were seen hanging out on trailers were pieces for a new crane. Here you can see the new crane that has been delivered. Jack Beyer has added some interesting information to the NSF video in the bottom left about this vehicle. It appears that they've already put all of the parts together for this new crane. I added this in the last video, but here's another view of those barrel sections seen sitting out in the yard. So cool. SpaceX recently intentionally destroyed the SN7.1 test tank and it has yet to be moved out of the launch area. Just wanted to include this since in the last video I said Elon hadn't tweeted about the pressure this tank reached. Many people pointed out my mistake, so here is his tweet about it. He said, 8 bar differential in ullage, 9 bar at base due to propellant head. It's enough, improvements in work. Moving on to the next prototype, here we have SN8 which was rolled out to the pad the other day. Not long after SN8 arrived, the crane was hooked up to the top as we were expecting it to be lifted onto the mount. Whilst I can't show it just yet, SN8 has been lifted onto the mount. However, for the last few days, engineers continue to work inside the LOX tank before the lift. Here you can see new road closure dates posted by Cameron County for SN8's first round of testing. Currently, there is a primary date of Sunday 4th with backup dates of Monday and Tuesday. As Elon Musk said in a recent tweet, SN9 will be up next in the coming month. Here we have some new aero surface covers spotted in the yard, these are possibly for SN9. Then, as they worked to get this tank stacked, the upper bulkhead ring stack was seen in front of the mid bay. SpaceX have since stacked this section with the rest of the tank to complete the methane tank. For SN9, we also have an updated build diagram from Brendan Lewis. Not too much left to do and I can't wait to potentially have 2 full-size Starships in October. Finally for this video, we also have even more for the first Super Heavy booster being constructed. Amongst the ring stacks we saw earlier is this barrel section which is labelled as one of multiple stacks for Super Heavy. So as you can see on Brendan's latest diagram, this is the second barrel section we can say is definitively for Super Heavy. We can never say for sure about anything until it's either built or written somewhere. However, Brendan tweeted some interesting speculation by saying the LOX tank bottom will be comprised of 5 stacks, each with 4 rings. The stack that was spotted by Mary says number 4, which could mean it's the 4th from the bottom. There are other 4 stacks laying around that could have labels saying LOX stack 1, 2, 3 and 5. I always like to say an enormous thanks to Mary or Boca Chica Gal for going out there every single day to film this incredible footage. Plus, there's the NASA spaceflight team also doing incredible work behind the scenes, so an enormous thanks to all of them as well. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show, I hope you enjoyed the video, if you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.